on this gloriously sunny September morning. I'm at Stanley Common, All Saints Churchyard, which is not far from Ilkeston in Derbyshire, and I'm here to come and look at two war graves that are here in the churchyard, which is at the back of the church building. And these two, I've already done the maintenance on them, which was just to trim the grass and give the stone a wash over. They weren't particularly dirty, but while I'm here, I like to do it. I've just wet them, and the sun is that warm, it's dried them out already. But the first one is to Lance Corporal Clare of the Royal Irish Regiment, who died on the 8th of March 1919. And then in the row behind, Lance Corporal Clare is Private D. Mails of the Royal Lancaster Regiment, who died on the 10th of December 1918. I've not done any research on these two casualties, but at some point in the future I will do. Wonder whether they knew each other. But as I walked in, I did find something interesting. Go in the shadow a little bit. This has definitely got a Great War connotation. Mr. Dilks was named Verdun, and he was born in 1916. It's not uncommon, that I've seen that before, but it's interesting to find it here at Stanley Common. Verdun, of course, was the big offensive that the Germans launched against the French in the early part of 1916, which ultimately brought the British to the Battle of the Somme to try and ease the pressure on the French and draw the Germans away from Verdun to defend the Somme. So there's echoes of the Great War everywhere you go in churchyards, either indirectly or directly, as with these two. This is one of three that I do in the Erewash Borough Council area. Stanley Common is just on the edge of Erewash, bordering on Amber Valley, which is where I do the majority of the cemeteries. But this is one in Erewash. That's the view of the church from the opposite side, the east side. As you can see, it's quite a modern church by church standards, built in brick. I would think it was probably built turn of the century, I'm not sure, but looking at the graves in here, there's nothing of a Victorian age. So I think the war graves were probably some of the earliest graves that were put in. I've just done a quick walk around. Can't find anything with any other military reference. it's quite a pleasant little churchyard, nice and peaceful, although the road on the frontage of the church is quite busy. At the back, it's very rural. So that's a little bit of a walk round Stanley Common, All Saints Churchyard. Just walking around the cemetery, see if I can find anything else with a Wargrave connection. This isn't Wargrave, but there's an interesting inscription. I've actually seen that before on other graves, but it's quite a sobering thought, really. Since visiting the churchyard, I have discovered that both men are named on the Mapley Colliery's war memorial. So, in answer to the question I raised earlier, they did know each other.